Have you seen it before?
I haven't. I've had no reason to go near this cursed lake until now. What of you?
I traveled the long way around it once before. Not so pleasant. Something about it just frays your nerves. Although, even being near it is enough.
No wonder you were assigned this mission.
At least we're taking the bridge this time. It'll only take 2 days instead of double that, and the sooner this place is behind us, the better.
It would be preferable not to risk it, but time is of the essence. We don't really have a choice.
I can also see why they chose you to come out here. You're always so calm and so serious. Nothing can get to you. You're the best choice they had. You know the town on the other side of the lake, though. It's not so similar to ours. If all goes well, perhaps we'll have enough time to enjoy the new area. Someone's already here.
Margaret.
Kika the Steadfast.
Bamele. Hello?
Where is the guide?
Unless he's on the center island, or on the complete other side, your guess is as good as mine. It's dark as pitch out there.
We can't cross without him, and we need to get going soon.
You can't cross with him, either.
What?
I know the guide will be here tonight. I have already made arrangements with him to cross. I have his word he'll take me today. It would be wiser for the two of you to begin the trip around if you're really in such a hurry. Or you can make camp here and wait for him to make the trip back if you prefer.
Even if that is so, my companion and I must begin the trip tonight. We'll wait for the guide to arrive before coming to a conclusion about any of this.
You can do as you like.
What's that bastard even up to?
With a mouth like that, you shouldn't even have the right to ask the guide to take you across.
How ludicrous. He's faced far worse than a bit of foul language.
Do you know anything that's happened with this lake?
I know enough.
The guide's father is Garvin the Exemplar. Garvin never accepted the guide as his son, all the way up until he died in this lake. Your statement could be seen as tasteless.
Oh. My apologies to the guide. I didn't mean it that way. I never knew about his... well, that.
I know you. You are brash, but not intentionally cruel. I'm sure all is well.
You're a good woman, Kika. Smart, too. You've never been here, yet you knew more of the guy than I did.
I know about Garvin, truthfully. Tales of his deeds were some of the only stories my parents ever told.
Is that so? You could tell me more about it sometime. I would like that very much.
Yes, I wouldn't mind that. It must wait until after this trip, though.
Of course. We should drop this topic sooner rather than later, in any case.
I agree.
Thank you.
Are you the guide of Sinlos?
Well, that's grand. We would like an escort across the lake.
Hello, it's good to see you again. I'm ready to cross, as we've agreed upon.
Is there a way we can all begin the trip tonight?
Yes, I will allow all three of you to go. But with that many, at least one will die before we reach the other side. You should go around.
We don't have time for that. There are people counting on us for protection. Why does she need to go?
I don't need to explain myself to you. My journey has already been put off once, and I was promised I could go today. I will be going under any circumstances. An extra day or two shouldn't be that much of a problem for you. Whoever you're meeting can surely wait such a tiny amount longer. Patience is a virtue, after all.
The night is only so long, and if we're still on the bridges when the sun comes up, we'll all die as they sink back below the surface. If you don't decide soon, no one will be going.
That woman isn't armed.
We can easily get her to back off if we make this into an actual fight. After all, we have to go tonight, yes? If one of us really is to die, it'll be her. Would staying be a worse fate than her death?
We don't know her situation. This isn't a decision we can make for her.
What?
The guide won't accept something like that, I assume.
Then what else do you have in mind?
First of all, you and I cannot split up. Either we both stay, or we both go.
Right. That's not a question.
And I believe you. We shouldn't waste more time. Let's shove off.
We should do what we can to protect her. It's our fault she's being put in even further danger.
Exactly my thoughts. We will take care of everything. Maybe I'm being naive, but I have no intentions of letting anyone fall victim to this lake tonight. Those monsters can starve.
We're lucky to have each other in this, I think.
Fall back a bit. You're following me too closely.
I'm sorry.
If someone gets pulled into the lake, they'll instinctively reach for anything to hold on to. Do not let that be you.
I understand. Thank you for the advice.
You can speak amongst yourselves if you so choose, as long as you pay attention to where you're going. There is no worth in listening to the sounds out there. If there's anything at all, it'll only be Nixie trying to set you on edge.
All right, then. Could you tell us your name? You didn't have a chance to properly introduce yourself, and I've only heard you being referred to as the guide.
I don't have a name.
Margaret, thank you for allowing us to join you.
It wasn't exactly up to me. The guide said he would take you. But thank you for saying that. It's appreciated.
Bemele and I will do our best to be an asset on this trip, rather than a burden.
That's nice. I'm not afraid to be out here, though. Still, at least with your training, you should be able to take care of yourselves.
taking care of yourself is exactly what you need to do. Work to survive at all costs, and hope that everyone around you has enough sense to do the same. That's the only way you'll make it to the other side.
Groups tend to go further when they work together to achieve the same goal.
I believe I saw something over there.
Keep walking. No need to worry.
What did he say?
Behind.
What on earth?
It's one of them.
Yes, Nixie that stumbled across the bridges looking for opportunities. The ones that can make it out of the water are generally referred to as prowlers.
Things like that were out here. Is that what Kika saw down the other path? Well, Nixie aren't slowed down much by swords, but at least light keeps them away, right?
Direct light will force it to return to the lake. However, it'll try to drag the light, or you, down with it before it goes.
Okay, does anyone have a light we can leave here? That way, it won't follow us.
Only matches.
Don't forget it's there, don't let your guard down, and don't get left behind.
What? How am I supposed to keep walking with this thing at my heels? You said it wants to attack.
Don't give it the chance.
Here, I'll lead you like this, and you can keep your focus solely on the Prowler. Make sure it doesn't get too close.
At least there's someone I can count on.
Kika, thank you.
Emily, they're stopping.
There's another one.
Don't get any closer. Give me a lantern. We'll throw it.
If you have to take someone's, take mine.
Yes, an extra light won't do as much good when we're standing this close together.
Thank you.
Stay here. I can't throw it too far. The light will blow out before it reaches the Nyx.
Thank you.
We should keep going before it comes back. Kika, thank you. Looked away for 1 second.
It's fine, Bemele. We're all fine.
Are you actually all right?
I am fine.
Kika, thank you. Again. You saved my life. I won't let this happen again.
Yes. Yes. It would be good for all of us to pay more attention.
Lost the lantern I threw. The Nyx grabbed it after the light went out.
It's better than them taking anything else.
We need to keep walking.
You can stay near me, Bemele, since your lantern is lost.
I appreciate it.
Like something's dripping down their faces.
I'm not sure.
Me neither. Something's wrong with them, though. They live in water. Air shouldn't be good for the things, but they want to drown humans so much they're willing to drag themselves around on land? It's not right.
Well, I don't disagree that there's something very wrong about them. I truly, truly hope that's the last we'll see of the Prowlers. You. Since you two have to share a light, wouldn't it be safer to be in the middle? That way, you'll catch the edges of my light and the guide's, and it won't be so dangerous if Bamele loses his position momentarily.
That's a very kind offer, Margaret. As thoughtful as it is, I, at least, am fine with bringing up the rear. I'm used to keeping watch for monsters, and since there are two of us, I can pay attention to the back while Kika focuses ahead. It's not my light, though, so I shouldn't be the one to decide what she should do with it.
So you're staying behind?
Seems like it.
Yes, I think we'll be good here. But really, thank you. That was a very kind offer.
Well, all right.
So, I don't want to sound like a child, but how much longer until we arrive at the halfway point?
We still have some ways to go.
Damn.
The first trial tends to be the most difficult. I believe we will only react better from this point on.
I like the way you think. I think Kika deserves a round of applause. Her quick reflexes are owed the utmost appreciation.
You're quite capable. Bemele was also a sight, but for very different reasons. The way he froze with his mouth all agape was a laugh in itself.
You should know, she and I are usually on equal footing.
The reason you had footing at all is because she pulled you back.
That's very true. You can always count on Kika.
What are you doing? Jump!
Thank you.
Why did we stop?
It's a man.
I'm sorry. I just couldn't. Please. I'm sorry.
Leave him.
No! We can't just leave him here. Without light, it's certain he'll die.
He won't make it regardless. Whoever shelters him will only risk dragging themselves down with him. Leave him. If the man comes, then whoever is shielding him will have to remain at a distance from the rest of the group. Far enough that you can't see me, just my light. That is how you will travel across the bridges. I didn't agree to lead this man, and I won't. If you ask me to, I will leave you all behind.
Are you well, stranger? Do you know where you are and why you're here?
I'm fine. You all can go on your way. Forget you even saw me here.
That's absurd. You have no way to defend yourself. We can't leave you.
Yes. I'm sure in your eyes I might not seem like much, but that's not exactly a fair shake. Maybe in a perfect world, every man would be as large as you. But that's not how things always go. It doesn't mean I'm defenseless.
What part of it was supposed to be the joke? Do you even realize what is happening in this moment?
Never mind. Forget that too. Point is, I'm alright.
You have found yourself out alone and unlit on Sinlos.
Exactly! Something must be wrong with you.
Oh no, sounds like you've been talking with my father.
That's not even the right way.
It is for me.
Oh? You must have come quite a ways if it was the other shore you started on.
Good. That's not so bad.
I still think he should come with us. A person needs a light, and the guide himself said he won't be able to manage on his own. Sticking with us is his best option.
It's easy for you to say such things, but whose light are you offering? It's not mine, and you are putting her in even more danger with your own presence already.
You... don't worry about me. I'll be on my way now.
We cannot lose another lantern at this point. We're almost to the island.
What are you planning?
Wait, are you going to throw that at them? What if the bridge sets on fire?
It will. You're going to run.
This is insane! These bridges are hellish enough without them also being on fire. And what about the other man? If he's still out there, this could...
He's dead. We're not losing another lantern. Don't get left behind.
It's the island.
Good work out there.
The sun will rise soon. The fire on the bridge is the only reason this island isn't overrun with prowlers right now. However, they could still pose a threat.
Is there something we should do? If any of you see anything at all, speak up. We don't want them to sneak up on us.
We no longer have to worry about the Nixie. It is over for today.
Hello.
Morning.
We should eat something soon.
Yes.
Nixie will not tread on land in daylight. However, being near the shoreline is still dangerous. If you leave the center of the island, remain cautious. Before the sun sets, I will be in this area. It would be wise to meet me here before nightfall.
Why do you do this? If you had just let him follow behind us, if you had been there before, none of this would have happened. They didn't have to die.
If all you're going to do is leave everyone to be lost, then why bother guiding us at all?
Wait!
Bemele, I know you're angry, but regardless of our feelings, we need the guide. If he leaves us, we'll all die.
And we've done so well with him.
We can't afford to lose our way.
I can't stay here right now. How are you faring? Any problems?
Everything is fine. I came to check on you.
How kind. I've calmed down since then.
I'm glad to hear that. Is there any way I can help or anything you'd like to say?
I didn't expect to see you so worried about me, Kika.
Have you seen the guide?
I saw him earlier. He is the same as always.
Good, good. In that case, I'm going to stretch my legs for a bit. I feel stiff from standing in one place for so long.
Hello there.